guys, welcome to my new Red Travelogue. It's a new travel show where we're going to be taking you all across the most beautiful places. In this show, my first episode today, of course, is going to Red Earth Kabini, a place called Kabini, very famous for its forest. How do you get there? I'm going to tell you. You basically drive from here, you go to the station, or you can take a bus. I'm going to take a train to Mysore, which takes about 2-2.5 hours. And from there, you take a car, you rent it, or you ask them to send you a car wherever you're staying. So basically, that's about 4 to 5 hours of travel, 2-2.5 hours from Bangalore to Mysore, and from Mysore you get to Kabini. Now I'm going to show you all the beautiful things that you need to see. Let's go check it out. Hi guys, welcome to the Travelogue, and I'm really excited. I'm at the Red Earth Kabini. Finally, it's actually a bit of a distance from about 1.5 hours from Mysore. These guys take care of the place and I'm really excited to look around at the property and also go to my room because the rooms are my favorite. Are you guys ready to take me there? Yeah? Also, they have some cool activities that are lined up for the day, so you got to follow me and I'm going to show you what's in store for you. So long, my trip has been absolutely amazing. Like, I'm having so much fun. It's filled with trees, with greenery, with nature. And if you actually stay silent, you can hear the birds chirp, which is just a great feeling. Now, this is where I'm going to spend the rest of my trip. So I'm going to hashtag home for the next few days. You guys check out what's coming next. As you can see, this place is just amazing. It's astounding. It's practically handpicked. Each and every item, as you can see, in this entire place is just so beautiful. And maybe get some grub after that. You guys check out what's on the spread. I can't wait. Guys, this is the refreshment drink that you get in the moment you come to this place, and they have this entire presentation, a room full of it, which I'm going to actually show you now, and they explain the entire property to you, so we're going to check how that goes. So I'm at the Red Earth Kabini restaurant. They have some really nice music in the 80s. It's a beautiful afternoon here. I'm actually not supposed to be eating sweets for my workout, but this is just like amazing. So this is the beetroot halwa they have, which is very close to gajar ka halwa. And this is like a strawberry thing. I haven't tasted this, but I'm gonna taste this one. This is just amazing. Something else. And I'm going to taste this one. Can I just act like Master Chef and do the consistency? No, I'm just going to cut to eat it. Oh my god. Can you see the reaction? It's too good. Should try the food here? Mental. So the best part that I liked, because I'm a very detailed person, is that every little thing here is so detailed, from this lamp to the lamps that are in the ceiling, in your rooms, in the restaurant. Each bit of furniture is picked up. Actually, I have a magical place to show you. I'm going to show you where that place is. Come. We are in a very southern part of India and it gets hot here. We all know how hot it gets. So what is the solution when you come out on a holiday because you don't want ACs, you want the nature? What gets us here is what we're going to find out.
Aar tingalu gon sari idana nav change martivi. Idu baseke time alli room olagade cool irutte.
Matte
resident time alli hot agirutte. Adu namge specific agi namge ee wall ella mud wall. Idana nav idralli brick use madilla. Idrinda namge tumba upayukta agide.
Some really good chai in a matka. You don't get that in the city for sure. We all know that. I'm at the Kabini Riverside. It's really, really nice. The sunset is just really heartwarming. Now the best part is, so there's this thing called, little boats called Atepa, which are made out of bamboo. And let's see if it's solid enough to carry us to the other side of the river. But I'm really excited for it because I've never gone on something like this. But I'm really excited. We're going to quickly finish this and head that side. You should check the sunset out as well. I'm in the middle of the Kabini River. Actually, it's not the river, it's the reservoir, but it's part of the river. And if you go a little ahead, you can see the river actually joining. The most interesting part about Kabini, I've read a lot of people who've written, who've come and stayed at the Red Earth Kabini, about how beautiful the sunsets are. We are about to check the sunsets. I'm really excited. See, I love sunsets. We all know how sunsets look. But when you're in the middle of a river and you're watching sunsets, that's the jungle kind of sunset that you don't want to miss. You know that whole saying that when you don't know what to do in life, take a holiday, and that's what I'm doing. I am at the Red Earth Kabini. It's beautiful, it's gorgeous. I have no words or adjectives. I'm in conversation with Aditya. Aditya and his parents and his family are the owners and people who take care of the Red Kabini here. I'm not shaking hands with you. I'm just going to do the namaskara because it's the whole coronavirus that's going on. But
True. We
are here on a holiday. This is fantastic. You guys got a beautiful place here. As a matter of fact, I've noticed that everything that you have is so tastefully picked up. Tell us a little bit about this entire place, how you guys
To be very honest, this started off as a hobby 10 years ago.
Okay.
I come from a plantation background. I'm a fifth generation tea and coffee planter.
Okay.
And back in the day, at least in the plantations, we used to entertain a lot of people. And these days, you can't sustain that lifestyle. So to live that same life, my parents and I came up with this. And personally, I like to cook, I like to entertain, and I love my wildlife. So this for me is more of a passion than work. So I love what I do, and that's how we came up with the idea.
When you say wildlife, I see a lot of pictures here on both the walls. These are taken by you guys?
Yes, it's clicked by me. I'm a part-time photographer. I fool around with the camera.
What are the best times that people should visit Red Earth Kabini?
From November all the way to end of May.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the best time for wildlife because Kabini is all about wildlife.
The forest and all
that.
Yeah,
but what we are trying to do off late is promote good living more than wildlife. So it doesn't have to be seeing a tiger. 99% or 100% of Indian tourists nowadays, wildlife tourists, are all about tigers. They're tiger centric.
Yeah.
The jungle is a lot more than that. You can sit back, enjoy the cool breeze, have a cool beer and enjoy yourself. You don't have to see a tiger.
So tomorrow we're taking a leap to the forest and yes, hopefully we're going to see some tigers. I really want to see some elephants because Kabini is very famous for that. But right now we're just going to enjoy the evening and I will catch you guys later. My second day sort of starts with me doing yoga just by the river. It's a beautiful feeling and by the sunrise itself. I took some time off to also monkey around, climb some trees just before I took the entire array of the breakfast spread at this lovely place. You guys should check it out. As they say, take care of thyself before you take care of thy men, and I think that is a golden rule for all women here, which is why I'm at the Swasti Spa. It is a spa in Red Earth Kabini, and it is just so beautiful, guys. Check this out. Isn't this pretty? It is, and yeah, I've gotten some cotton stuff for the dull eyes, and I'm gonna go inside. You see, nature is always very mystified, and which is why I'm at the Kabini forest and I'm going to go check out this place. Now, if you know the language or not, doesn't matter. Two things that you must remember is that there's a counter here and all the forest officers are very, very helpful. Either take a bus into the forest or you can take a private jeep. Both of this is available at the counter itself. So I'm going to go ahead and watch some tigers and elephants, and I'm really, really excited. So yeah, guys, follow me. Let's check out what's inside the forest. And 2 nights at the Red Earth Kabini was just absolutely fantastic. We had a great time, from hospitality to the food to the rooms. Everything was just brilliant. You guys need to check out the food that they have. It's really different. They've got different kinds of cuisine. The staff is very friendly. Most importantly, it's a sustainable figure of of a system. There are tons of things to do, whether you want to do some activities on the river or you want to go to the safari right into the Kabini forest. It's your choice, but we can tell you all your options are open and you'll get all your options right here at the show. I'm heading back. I had a great time here. I'm heading back to Bangalore now. I hope you guys loved watching this. I'm going to get you so much more episodes of traveling and going out and exploring all by yourself. Share it and subscribe and keep listening to Super Hits 93.5 Red FM. But jaate raho. Red FM 93.5.